In this video, I'm going to talk about the definition and some examples of topological spaces. Let me start with the definition of a topological space. Let X be a set and let tau be a collection of subsets of X. We say that tau is a topology on X if the following conditions are satisfied. The empty set is in tau and X is in tau. If G alpha for alpha in I is a collection of sets such that G alpha is in tau for all alpha in I, then their union belongs to tau. If this condition is satisfied, people say that tau is closed under arbitrary union. If G1 is in tau and G2 is in tau, then the intersection of G1 and G2 belongs to tau. And this means that tau is closed under the intersection of two sets. And by induction, we can show that if this condition is satisfied, then tau is closed under finite intersection. If tau is a topology on X, then the pair X tau is called a topological space. In the case when no confusion occurs, we say that X is a topological space with the understanding that there is a topology on X. Next, I'm going to talk about the definitions of an open set and a closed set in a topological space. Let X tau be a topological space. If G is in tau, then G is called an open set in this topological space. A subset f of x is said to be closed if its complement is open. Assume that tau 1 and tau 2 are two topologies on x. We say that tau 1 is weaker than tau 2 if tau 1 is a subset of tau 2. This means that if a set G is open in x with tau 1, then G is also open in X with tau 2. Next, I'm going to talk about some examples of topological spaces. Given a set X, we define below some topological structures on X. Let tau 1 be the collection of subsets of X consisting of only the empty set and X. We can easily verify that tau 1 is a topology on X, and it is called the indiscrete topology on X. In X with the indiscrete topology, the empty set and X are the only open sets. We can also verify that they are the only closed sets in this topological space. In the second example, we consider a subset A of X and define tau 2 by this formula. So tau 2 contains the empty set X, A, and the complement of A. We can prove that tau 2 is in fact a topology on X in this topological space, the empty set X, A, and the complement of A are the only open sets. At home, you can show that these are the only closed sets in this topological space. In the third example, let tau 3 be the collection of all subsets of X, which means that tau 3 is the power set of X. It is obvious that tau 3 is a topology on X, and it is called the discrete topology. In X with a discrete topology, every set is both open and closed. Based on their definitions, we have the following inclusion. Tau 1 is weaker than tau 2, and tau 2 is weaker than tau 3. In fact, tau 1 is the weakest topology on X, and tau 3 is the strongest topology on X. Finally, we are going to talk about another topology structure. Given a set X and consider the collection of subsets of X defined as follows. Tau contains all subsets of X such that its complement is finite along with the empty set. In the next video, we are going to prove that tau is a topology on X and it is called the finite complement topology. Let's consider a particular case where X is R and tau is the finite complement topology on X. Then this set is open in X with the finite complement topology because its complement is a single point set, which is a finite set. However, if A is the interval from 0 to infinity, then A is not open in this topological space because its complement is not finite. This completes our video on the definition and some examples of topological spaces. Thanks for watching.